Hey guys, I found an awesome little ripper. Just look at this, guys. And this guy's got everything that you want inside an RC car. Stay tuned. So guys, in today's video we've got another very boring box to look at, but what's inside this box isn't boring. So inside here we will find a trophy truck with a brushless setup, metal gears, ball bearings and a lot more, and it's pretty affordable. So let me get everything out of the box and show you what's inside here. Inside the box you will find the car, the transmitter, we've got some instructions, a different front bumper with some spare bits and pieces, we've got some tools, a USB charger, a 1500 milliamp lithium ion battery, and we've got a set of oil shocks. So out of the factory, this car just simply has got friction shocks, but you will get a set of oil shocks, and that's always a good thing. And listen to this, guys. Do you hear that? That sounds awesome, but let's have a closer look at the transmitter first. This is the transmitter and it runs on 3 AA's, which you need to supply of your own. So it's capable of one-hand driving and the build quality feels very sturdy. So far, I really like this transmitter. So on top of the transmitter, you will find your on-off switch, your steering reverse, your steering trim and your dual rate. And right over there is your speed selector. So all the way to the right is your low speed, middle is medium speed and all the way to the left is high speed. And this car should do 70 kilometers an hour. And right over there is channel number 3 and this is for controlling the lights. So let's have a closer look at the car now. And here is the car, guys. What do you think of the appearance? Well, appearance-wise, I really do like this car. It looks a bit short in my opinion, but it doesn't matter. This car feels very, very sturdy, and I really do like the appearance of it. So I paid around $100 for this car, and you will get a whole lot of cars. So we've got metal drive lines, metal gears, a brushless setup, ball bearings, and a lot more. So I'll put a link down below to this car so you can check it out for yourself. But this car really looks promising already. So let's have a closer look at some details now. In the front of the car you will find the front bumper, but this isn't the front bumper, this is. So this is like an extra piece which is mounted to the body and therefore it's like an impact barrier and I really like that. So inside this grille you will find an LED bar. We've got an LED bar sitting right over there and we've got some LEDs over there. So inside this body you will find a roll cage with two drivers inside there, so I really like that as well. So in the rear of the car we've got a very big plastic piece which actually holds the spare tires in place and the rear bumper. So the body itself, it feels very sturdy. So when we turn the car around, you can see a plastic chassis. We've got plastic arms and that's all fine. So we've got a wheelie bar sitting there, you know, and overall the build quality feels very sturdy. But let me get the body off and show you what's under there. On the inside of the body you will find all the plastic reinforcement to give it more stability and I really like that. And underneath the body, guys, here is all the magic. Just look at this. This car feels very, very solid and very sturdy. So right over there is your brushless motor. So this is a 2847 4000 kV brushless motor. And this is your 2-in-1 receiver EC combination. So from here we've got a 3-wire servo and this is a 17-gram servo with a servo saver pre-installed. So we've got a lot of metal parts inside there. As mentioned, we've got metal gears, we've got metal drive shaft. This piece is also made of metal. On the front of the car you'll find metal cups, metal CVDs, metal carriers. In the rear the same story, so metal cups, metal dark bones, metal carriers, you know, there is a lot of metal parts, which is always a good thing. So the arms are made of a very flexible material. Just look at this, I can easily bend them and that's a good thing. So if you're hitting an obstacle, this normally will flex and doesn't break as easily. So I really like that. So overall the build quality, it feels very sturdy and it looks pretty promising. So let me throw in some batteries and show you when it's on. The car's powered on and this is the steering servo. So we've got plenty of speed but it doesn't have got a lot of power. So that's a bit of a downside, but it is what it is. So throttle wise, this is full throttle at the low power setting. Whoa, that makes a lot of noise, but let's put it in the middlest one. Whoa, and now in the high speed. Whoa, it's very noisy, but this goes pretty fast, I think. So let me draw on the body and show you the light system. Here you can see the lighting system. So we've got some orange LEDs in the front, we've got some white ones on top of there, and we've got some red ones sitting in the rear. So you can turn them on like this, or you can do the slow flashing, or the rapidly flashing, or you can turn them off. So before I'm going to take this one outside, I'm going to install the oil sharks, and then we're going to bash it around. Stay tuned. So guys, we're at the tarmac road, and the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to see how fast this car can go. So let's go. I gave it a couple of runs and we hit the 50 kilometers an hour. So not the 70 they claim on the box, but you know, still this is a pretty fast car. So let's take it off road. So guys, I've been driving this car around for a couple of minutes now, and I must say I'm pretty impressed, but there's one big problem. So now we hit a little bit of taller grass, and when I try to drive away, it doesn't happen, as you know. So it's a lot of cogging in the slow modulation, and that's a big downside. You see, that's full power and it just doesn't go. So first reverse again, and now when you have a little bit of momentum, then it goes, then it rips. You see that? So I think that's pretty annoying, but it is what it is. Another thing is the steering servo. So the steering servo isn't pretty strong, and therefore sometimes in the taller grass when you try to steer, it doesn't really steer. So that's a bit annoying, but it's got plenty of power and you can do wheelies all day. Here it goes. Whoopa! Oh, crashed it again. You know, it's pretty durable. I crashed it like a million of times already, but yeah, so you know, for the money you will pay around $100 for this car, and I think you can have tons of fun with it. So I will just give you some driving footage now, and then I will come back to you with my final thoughts about this car. So guys, that was the driving with the JJRC, the Q130 Pro. And what do I think of this car? Well, appearance-wise, I really like this car. I really like the body art and the orange color. Of course, you can choose some different colors. I will put the link down below so you can check those out for yourself. But I really do like the roll cage, the figures inside there, the lighting system, the two spare tires on the rear, and also all the reinforcement inside this body. So I rolled it around like a couple of times, and still it's in one piece. So the body for me, that's a thumbs up. So performance wise, they advertise it with 70 kilometers an hour, and it can't do 70. We hit 50 kilometers an hour, which is still a pretty decent speed for a car of this size, you know. But why advertise with 70 if it can do only 50? So maybe that's a bit of a downside. Another thing what I really don't like about this car are the shocks. So factory off, these simple friction shocks are installed, and that's a big downside. But in a separate bag, I got those oil filled ones. But you have to fill them with oil yourself, and you you have to install them yourself. So that's a bit of a downside and still a plus thing, you know, because you will get oil shocks with the car. So yeah, I don't know about that. Another thing is the motor and the ESC. So after running one battery, it was pretty warm. So I waited a couple of minutes before I run another one. Otherwise, I can overheat the motor and the ESC. So just, yeah, keep that in mind if you're going to run this car. But overall, for the money, so you will pay around $100, I think it is, for this car. I will put the link down below so you can check it out for yourself. I think that you will get a very decent car. We've got a metal driveline, you know, metal gears, ball bearings inside there, oil shocks, you know, brushless setup. So overall, for the package, I think that's all fine. Alright guys, that was it for today. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. If you've got any questions or suggestions, leave a comment below. And I will see you in the next video. Bye bye!